In this tutorial, we learn how to import Half-Life models into Blender. We also learn how to animate these models, how to import Half-Life maps and sounds, and lots of extra tips along the way. Let's go! First, you need a copy of the Half-Life game. Then, you need to download the add-on that lets you import Half-Life models into Blender. I personally like to use Source.io, because this add-on also supports other Valve games, which is very nice. Download the add-on as a zip file. Open Blender and go to Preferences, Add-ons, press Install and select the Source.io master zip file. It should appear in this list with a check mark on. Next, let's import some models. Use this File Import menu, or press F4 in the viewport. Select Source Engine Assets, Gold Source Model. You can speed up your workflow by adding this menu to Quick Favorites. Navigate to your Steam folder, Steam Apps, Common, Half-Life, Valve. Then press this plus icon to mark this folder as a favorite, so you can find it faster next time. In the Models folder, we find all game models, NPCs, enemies, props, weapons, and player models. Some of these models have extra parts in them, like weapons or different heads. I usually just delete stuff I don't need. Most of these models come with a very simple rig that you can already use to make animations. To make these bones bigger, select the armature, go to Data Properties, Viewport Display, and change this type to B Bone. Then switch to Edit Mode. Select all bones with A shortcut. Press Ctrl+Alt+S and scale the bones smaller. You can animate the model in Pose Mode by adding keyframes manually or by using auto keying down here. Doing complex animations by hand can be hard, but luckily we also have an option to get smooth animations without doing too much extra work. We can use this site called Mixamo that has free animation presets that we can use on Half-Life's human models. But first we need to prepare our model so it works there. First we need to get rid of the old rig by deleting it. Save the blend file. Then we need to go to File, External Data, Unpack Resources. Choose this top option. Blender extracts the model's textures in the same folder as it was saved. Then go to File, Export, FBX. Change this path mode to Copy. And click this embedded textures icon. And save the file. Log into Mixamo. Upload character. If you see your guy textured and all, you've made it. Next, we add a rigging markers like in the picture. You can use this no fingers rig if you get an error message, or if your animations are wonky. Next, you can start experimenting with different animations. I'll just choose a running animation so we can continue. Depending on your choice, you might want to check this in-place option if it's available. It is easier to animate the location in Blender than use this few seconds clip. Download the model. Choose the FPS you want to use in your project and hit Download. In Blender, import FPX and choose your animation. Running man, amazing. Easy way to extend this animation duration is to drag a new workspace and go to non-linear animation. Then press this push down action and open the actions clip tab. Here you can increase the repeat value to get longer animations. If you want to combine multiple Mixamo animations together, import all of them to Blender. Move them apart so you can see what they are doing. Back in non-linear animation workspace, double-click the action and rename them so you know what they do. Then press this push down button. Now you can remove the extra armatures and models from the scene. Then add the clips you want to use to your timeline. These two clips don't mix well together, so we need to move them apart a little. Select them both and add a transition. If you need to tweak the clips, you can press Tab to enter to edit mode. Then you can edit the keyframes of that action. If you want to attach weapons or other props to your character, you can choose a bone in pose mode. Then select the object and parent them to that selected bone. Other way to parent objects to your armature is to use child of constraint. Select the armature and desired bone. You might have to tweak the object's position and press these set inverse or clear inverse buttons to get it right. Nice! Next, we will import Half-Life map into the scene. But before that, you want to go to View, Navigation, and assign a shortcut to this walk animation. I'm using Shift F. This lets you navigate the scene with WASD keys like in FPS games. You can also press the Tab key in this mode to activate gravity, and you can actually walk in your scene. I also recommend to press N to get this panel. And in the View tab, adjust the focal length, so it's easier to navigate the maps. There are two ways of importing Half-Life maps into Blender, and I'm going to show them both, because both ways have their pros and cons. The first way is to use Source IO add-on we got before, but you choose this gold source map option. Maps can be found in the Maps folder. These are basically in the order the game plays. First you have the train scene and so forth. There are also deathmatch maps included. I'll just choose a random map. Do you think what the Source IO add-on does is it also imports game models and NPCs into the scene, so you can easily recreate the scene from the game. These are separate, so you can move and delete them as you wish. There are two types of in-game triggers, purple boxes or Gabe's head. You can remove them by pressing Shift L and select Linked Materials, and press X to delete. Other way to import maps is to use an external program called Crafty. There's a link in the Valve Developers Wiki. I downloaded the archive version. What this program does is it imports the map without NPCs and objects. It also works with some maps that Source IO cannot import. You can also import maps from other games and mods. Just set the profile to Half-Life Now and open the map you want. You can move in the scene with WASD keys and holding the right mouse button to rotate the view. Export the map into its own folder, because textures will be also saved there. In Blender, before you import the map, open the Source IO map importer and copy this world scale number, so the map doesn't import super big. Import waveform OBJ. Paste the scale here. Change the forward axis to X or Y and up axis to Z. Next, you want to position the map, so the scene you are working on is around the world center. Our running man can help with this one. When you switch to rendered mode, you can see that the scene is dark. I recommend to add aerial lights that you can customize easily. If you turn on snapping up here and set the snapping to face protection, you can duplicate these lights with Alt-D shortcut. That creates a linked light that you can adjust all together to save time. Disable the snapping when you don't need it anymore. Next, we need to add a camera to the scene. You can get to the camera view with this icon or number 0. Now when you hit Walk Animation shortcut, you can move the camera to a point you like. Adjust the focal length if needed. When you want to have multiple cameras, in the timeline, press M to create a marker. Then press Ctrl B to bind the camera to this marker. Then duplicate the camera. Press this icon to make it active. And position it to another place. Go forward in the timeline and bind the second camera. You can move these markers to change the pace. Next, we will add location keyframes to our running man. Press T in the timeline and change the interpolation to linear to make the running consistent. Next, let's import some sounds. Add a new workspace for video editing. And change this view to 3D viewport. And set it to rendered view. Press number 0 to go to the camera view again. You can find all sound files in the game folder called sound. I'll add some player step sounds for the running. You can also drag sound straight to the viewport. Then you can play the animation over and place the sounds to the right spots. Let's render this bad boy next. Go to Output and change the folder to something else. Change the file format to FFmpeg video. And change the encoding to MPEG4. Change the audio to include MP3 audio. And render away. Please tag me to the videos you create. I would love to see them. Thanks for watching and see you next time.